Welcome to Jilster, an open online and free platform for you to create magazines, books, posters, and photo collages together. My name is Chelsea, and if you're new here, thank you and welcome to the Makerspace. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the Makerspace and show you all the new functionalities and elements for you to use. So let's get into it. Okay, so once you're logged in, you're brought to all your creations, which is what you see on the screen now. Here's where you can either continue editing, make a new design, or even place an order. But today I would like to walk you through the process of making a new design. So let's click the Make a Design button, and let's begin with a magazine. Now we are in our creations overview, and we're just going to change the title to Makerspace Walkthrough for now. And you can see that when we begin a new creation, you start with all these blank pages. And when you want to begin a page, for instance the cover, just hover over it and click the Start button. The first thing we're going to see are all these amazing templates that are all free for you to use to help guide and inspire you during the process of your creation. You can even use these templates to create your own template for future use. I recommend browsing through the templates and clicking on the cover to open it up and check out all the different page designs, just as this wedding magazine. Okay, so before we begin creating, I just want to bring your attention to the big main toolbar where we have templates, backgrounds, text, elements, and folders. This is the toolbar for you to use to place elements onto the page, but today let's make a birthday magazine and start with the B-Day Star template, and we will place the cover onto the page. Now, in order to customize the template, we first have to upload our own images, so let's go to the folders button, click images, and I already pre-selected images for this tutorial, so I'm just going to drag them into the box here. You can also select your own images and not drag them by just clicking the select tool and click open. Okay, so let's delete the image of the cover by clicking the delete on our keyboard or by using the delete button here, this little trash bin. And then we will drag the image we want onto the page. When you select any element on the page, this mini tool guide with four icons will appear. You see the trash bin, the duplicate button, the layers, and the flip. And the duplicate is just as I just showed you right there. You just duplicate easy, and then you can just delete that. And now let's make the image larger by just pulling the dots and dragging it outwards. But now you see the image covers all the text. So let's go back to the mini tool guide and click the layers button. Now we can send the image backwards so the text will appear in front. So let's do that by clicking the arrow. And you see everything's coming along. All right, now we have the flip feature, which flips objects to the page, whether you want to flip it vertically or upside down, or if you want to flip it side to side. I want to show you how to change the background of the cover, but my image right now is too big and covering the entire page. So let's just make this image a little smaller. Then on the left side of the toolbar, you have the option to either select different types of background images to use in your creation, or you can even decide on a specific color. So let's try some different options and see what we like. But now that our image is smaller, I can walk you through the image tools, where we can edit the image any way we like. Over here on the top toolbar, you see the filters, crop, border, shadow, transform, and transparency button. These are the tools for you to edit the objects on the page. For starters, if you want to edit the image color, there are filters you could try, such as grayscale, sepia, or technicolor. Feel free to test them all out or use no filter at all. You can also adjust the brightness, the contrast, the hue, and the saturation and the blur of the image to like make it cool, playful, and I must say it's pretty fun to play with the color of the image. But next we have the crop tool, so we'll select the crop, and then you will see an outlined box that will appear. So you'll just adjust the outlined box to whichever part of the image you would like to crop. And then once we have that selected, we're just going to click apply. There we have it. Now we have a cropped image, but I actually liked it before, so I'm going to first send it backwards because maybe it will look good here. But I don't know, I liked the bigger image. So then I will use the back arrow all the way up on top where you see the back and the forward arrow. So I'll just go back and then there's the image from the original size. Now if you want to add a border, we're going to select border, and then you select the color that you want of the border, and then go over here to the width and you slide this toggle, and you can make it thicker or thinner depending on the vibe of your magazine or your look and feel, I would say. And you can always change the color or add a shadow to the border as well. Adding elements such as light and shadow can add qualities like depth and dimension and perspective to your design. So when we click the shadow tool, we have different options we can choose depending on how we want our shadow. However, it doesn't really show on this black background, so I'm going to change the background to white so we can see the effect of the shadow. Honestly, when it comes to designing with light and shadows, there's so much we can talk about. So if you want a separate video on this topic, just please comment and we will discuss it. Next, we have the transform button. To get more accurate results, you can use this transform tool to make the image a certain size by typing in the dimensions and the X and Y coordinates to width and height of the image. You can see when I adjust the X coordinate, the image will move horizontal, and I can also just change the width and size of the image. This tool is really helpful to make creations consistent and especially handy when you want to make a spread in your magazine. But we will go into how to make a spread so much deeper in another video, so please stay tuned for that. The next tool we have on the top toolbar is our transparency tool, which we can edit the transparency of the image by using this tool and sliding the toggle to the right. At the moment, we have all this text on the cover, so we want to edit this text and customize it to make it more of our story. To begin customizing the text, just select the text, and then we are going to change B-Day star to Alexis, and then change the font by just going over here and trying out different fonts, seeing which we like, and what our overall goal of this magazine is. Next, we have size, where we can decide the font size of our text. So we can make it larger or smaller. See, that's too big, but it's cool, but it's a little bit too big. So we'll make it a little smaller and go back to the original. Then under text style, you can make the text bold, italic, underlined, or even with a line through it. And you also have the align tool to align your text, whether it's to the left, the center, right, or full. If you would like to use columns, you can easily click on how many columns you would like, from 2 to 4. Using columns will help you break up the layout of the page, especially if it's full of text, and can help you fit more text onto a page and provide better readability. We also have line height, which is commonly used to set the distance between the lines of the text. It defines the amount of space above and below the text. There's no perfect line height, but we suggest you use this tool to help with the readability of your creation. We also have letter spacing, which is the space between the letters. It is very fun to play with this tool, especially with the heading or the title of your creation. And if to undo any changes, just use the back or forward arrows. Under elements, you can find all different kinds of clip art and decorative items, such as these flowers or photo frames that you can use in your creation. You can also find a collection of shapes and lines in the elements category, in which you can click the shape you want and it will automatically place on the page. So let's play with these flowers first. And let's make the page a little more fun. When rotating the image, you can just use the dot and just swing it the direction you want. And you can use the dots to change the size of the shape and so on. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Always remember to save the page. And when you want to finish and create an order, you would have to approve the pages. You have to approve all the pages within your creation in order to place an order. Okay, and we are done. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe to this channel and turn on your notifications for more tips and tricks. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate. Always remember, your story matters, and Jilster is always here to help you collaborate in capturing and sharing stories that matter. See you next time.